Hello, all my beautiful sheepies. Hello! Welcome to the RPG tabletop stream. We're going to be playing a campaign run by our own Nightwing. I'm about to join the call. I just want to say hello, and I hope you're all doing well. I hope you're all comfortable, and you better have snacks and better be ready, because it's going to go off at lightning speed. So let's do this shit.
Wow.
Nagida.
Wow.
Stretched us.
Wow.
Also, that moment you open the stream and you double hear wow, so it's even more intense. Wow.
Exactly.
Wow. Oh, I heard that crack. Ow.
Are you okay?
I got a redeem for stretch because I had to. I had to take off all the other rewards we had for the stream just so people don't have me in the middle of character going,
No. You can't take it down.
I have to.
That's illegal. No.
I have to.
Damn.
They can save their points so they can wreck me on Monday.
Yeah.
They can wreck me on Monday for it. They'll save their points up. I get to mod all of you. That's all dirty. Okay, so what I'll have playing in the background, I did find a supposedly royalty-free stream-friendly playlist.
Lovely.
Namor! Thank you for doing the subby sub. Thank you.
If you get canceled for no reason, I guess we know why. It was not
D&D. It says it's stream-friendly, so hopefully. It does say epic royalty-free music on the thing. It's a full commercial license pack. So, I'm hoping...
How much is it?
Thank you. Huh?
How much is
it? It's on Spotify.
Oh? Then use it.
Yeah, so I'm like, I'll use it, and then if I get flagged for it, I get flagged for it. They'll be like, hey, don't do it again. It'll just mute part of the stream, but I'm like, whoever's watching can still hear it. But, like, it just kind of plays random opening songs. It does have a Final Fantasy cover, so maybe not. But I'll lower it a little bit, so it's just in the background. Wait, I know this song. It has a Persona 5 in there! It has Light Will Change.
I may or may not start just randomly dropping some subs, so you know.
Ooh, that would be dope, though. Oh, did you see, I have the new, I have the bronze one. Did you do it? Which one do you have? You have two months. What do you have? I'm looking at all the badges.
What do I have? Am I 4 months?
You are 3 months. So I think at first, at 1 month and 3 months, it's the first one, which is the pink. And then I think it's 6 months is the bronze. 9 months is silver. And then a year and upwards, as far as I can do, because I'm not a partner yet, is gold and shiny.
Panty.
Pretty,
yes. But hi, Nagi. How have you been? I haven't seen you in a while. Nagi's in the stream. I haven't seen Nagi in a while.
Yep.
It's Nagi.
So, I have the music playing in the background. We are good to go.
Yeah. And so the stream can hear us?
Yes, the stream can hear. Can you hear us, stream? Shout if you can.
Wow.
That's unfortunate. I was...
Yes, they can hear us.
Oh dear. Wow. I am... How are you? I'm okay. Inside, not on the outside. On the outside, I have to go to work, and my arms are not happy about that.
No, oh, poor thing.
Your arms?
I have to clean up after a football game, and I'm not looking forward to
fuck.
It.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, ew, gross.
Yikes. Oh, jeez.
Yo, I'm gonna get some Smurfs. Got some of these Haribo Smurfs. This stream has been brought to you by Haribo.
Haribo. The gummy bears just jump on us.
Tonight we are sponsored by Haribo and Monster. Not really, but if they want to sponsor us, yeah.
That's a deadly combination, Haribo and Monster. That's
just put
like...
the Haribo at the bottom. Have a good snack.
Yeah, you just throw them in.
Oh.
And it'll absorb Monster.
Oh, that would be interesting. Or Monster flavored gummy bears.
I'm doing good, Nagi. I hope you have been amazing. You better be. I swear. And even busy.
Breaking sweat. We're not okay. We're gonna have problems.
Yeah. You're gonna fight. Not physically. Say love yourself.
I'll fight you physically.
You'll get your nose flicked. That's it.
Ow.
Hurt yourself and I'll hurt you. That's how this works.
That sounds very painful.
That sounds lovely. That sounds lovely. Twice the pain. Hell yeah.
I call it the double down syndrome.
Just so much pain. So much pain.
Not me, probably gonna be sketching eyeballs the entire time.
Alright, let's do this.
Let's do these?
Yes.
Oh dear.
So does chat know what we're doing?
Yeah, they don't really know much about besides there is a like D&D/RPG game playing.
Yes.
That's all we know.
Alright, well in that case, shall I assume my position as tonight's game master?
Yes.
Please don't use that term. God, that sounds terrible.
Game master.
All right, I'll use the term narrator. Let's go with that.
No, the assuming the position.
All right. Well, hello everyone. Welcome to the stream. Super excited to have you all here. I'm super excited to get to do this. This is going to be a weird stream because I have not DM'd a game in some time. So bear with us. There's going to be lots of chicanery tonight because we have three jokers bumbling around the Starship Valiant. Tonight, we are playing with the system Roll for Shoes. If you need to look it up, you can, but the rules are super simple, so I'm just going to tell you all them right now. Rule number one, each character has a skill. That skill is Do Anything 1. That means if at any point during the game you try to do something that has any chance of failure, you roll one die, I roll one die. Whoever rolls higher wins. If you succeed at what you're doing and roll a 6, you immediately get a better skill in whatever it was you're doing. So if you're punching someone in the face, you might get punching 2, or punching faces 2, or however you want to flavor it. And then anytime you do something that utilizes that skill, you roll 2 dice, pick the higher number. If both those dice come up 6s, you get an even better skill at level 3, and so on and so forth. I can increase the number of dice I'm rolling to make things harder for you guys. You guys can increase the number of dice you're rolling based on environmental factors and such. Tonight, we are playing in a sci-fi setting of my own making. We will be playing with a couple of safety tools. You chat will see them as they come up. They hopefully will not be used, but we have them just in case. As always, chat, please don't be dinguses to the players. Please don't be dinguses to each other. We're here to have fun and chill on the Starship Valiant. That out of the way. The camera fades into a starship. We see it traveling across the horizon. And as the starship kind of approaches, it gets close enough to where it kind of meets the horizon, we see a little bit of a flashback. You three are on board the Starship Valiant. The Starship Valiant, the UEA Starship Valiant, is an exploration ship. Its goal? To travel to a distant planet, nicknamed Darwin's Planet for the man who discovered it. And your job is to hopefully colonize it. And if not colonize it, at least figure out why it's not colonizable and report that information back to the UEA. UEA stands for United Earth Alliance. It is kind of a beginnings of the Star Trek Federation type deal. Humanity has made contact with one or two alien species, but not really anything. And Darwin's Planet potentially has life on it, so, you know, colonize it, make contact with alien races, and it's far away, so you guys got put into cryosleep to kind of make the 60-year-long journey not affect you guys as much. There's a robot crew that will be running the ship in the meantime. They will wake you up when you arrive at your destination, and the last memory that most of you guys have is being placed in your cryopod and the lid sealing over top of you. And now you dream. And it's a very weird dream because you don't really wake up. You just kind of transition from dream to blackness, almost like the static that happens when you're changing TV channels. It's just kind of there. You don't really know what's beyond it. And let's meet our small little intrepid cast of dreamers. Going based on our order in the chat group that I can see, we're going to start on our very left with Spec. Spec, who are you playing as tonight?
Hello, I am playing as Heldeki Morthos, Bard. He is the DJ, in a way.
Nice. kind of the morale officer type character, correct?
Yes.
Lovely. Next to Spec, we have the ever mighty, ever wonderful Meme Lord. Meme Lord, who are you playing as tonight?
Amen. Well, first, I would just like to give a big wow to that, but I am playing Francis Lloyd. He is a human. He is a doctor, but specializes in psychiatry. His job was to ensure the mental health of the crewmates and maybe the AI.
Lovely.
And then do I say my trait?
No, you do not have to say that just yet. Okay. That will come up as we play. So, we have our morale officer, we have our doctor. So, Blue, who are you playing as tonight?
Wait, I just wanted to get write down Meme Lord. What was the name of your character again? Just the name?
Francis Lloyd.
Francis Lloyd, okay. I was trying to type on Hildaki's Francis.
When referring to him, it is Dr. Lloyd.
Yes.
Dr. Professor Lloyd.
Dr. Professor.
If you've had a few drinks. Lloyd.
Dr. Professor, your honor, Judge Lloyd. All right, so for my character, we have Joseph Miller. That was a name given to him. He is the main chef of the kitchen on the ship. His main thing is in terms of being in the main trait is in terms of being in the kitchen, fine. But as soon as he's nervous in any other situation, does not have a good time, becomes clumsy. So known as the clumsy chef. And that's Chef basically Boyardee. It as of right now. Chef Boyardee, yes. And that's pretty much a cat-based alien that is now among the crew. Just chilling and vibing.
So lovely.
And hello, pretty much trash.
Yes, that's hello, not welcome. You're not trash.
But thank you, welcome. If you want to put your pronouns in the chat, please put it down. I'll write it down. But thank you for joining us.
That's my husband.
That's the husband.
Hello, welcome.
I probably not do anything trash? Wrong to your husband. Or is this some self-abuse we got going on?
Yeah, don't fucking hug. Not trash!
Meme Lord does not tolerate this.
Unless you're
this
raccoon. Wait, are you a raccoon? Are you actually just raccoon? Are you
trash panda? They're definitely trash panda.
Aww.
Ooh, lovely.
Lovely.
Alright. Well, speaking of putting pronouns in the chat, just to make sure that I have everyone's pronouns correct, you guys have all referred to your characters as he. Do your characters use he, him, or he, them, or some other form of that?
Mine is pretty much just he, him, though it is pretty much being called it in it, and he does not enjoy that, so...
Hey, Morthos is an alien, then?
No, they're a tiefling.
So that would be... okay.
That would be an alien in this place.
So they're like, they're basically a demon-based alien, essentially. A tiefling.
Yes.
That is perfect. Meme Lord Blue, you guys also use he, him, or...
Yes.
Yarp.
And then human.
Perfect. I also respond to, hey, you.
Lovely.
Hey, you's guy.
Alrighty. Well, with that out of the way, Morthos, Dr. Lloyd, Miller, you guys see... suddenly, in the blackness, a sliver of light. It's very faint at first, but as your eyes open, the light suddenly transforms into the harsh glare of neon lights positioned directly above your slowly opening cryogenic sleep chamber. You sit up, your pupils dilating very quickly to absorb in all the light that is coming into your senses, and you look around, you see yourself in a chamber filled with several rows of cryopods, much like the one you're sitting in. Some of them are open, some of them are closed. You can see that generally a lot of the ones that are closed are empty. A lot of the ones that are open either have people in them or have people standing by them. Everyone is wearing generally the same level of clothing, which is basically just underpants and then a very thin kind of slipper type thing to keep your feet warm from the cryogenic freezing. And as you guys sit up, you hear this kind of clanking sound coming in from the doorway at the far left of the room. And as the clanking sound grows louder and louder, this robot walks into the room. And the robot looks kind of humanoid. It has a humanoid body, it's got two arms, two legs, but the designers were very careful not to approach the uncanny valley. So it's got a box head, you can see some of its circuitry, it's got three-fingered hands, it's got kind of a flat slab for a foot. It's about a meter and a half tall, and it walks in and just kind of addresses everybody in general, just kind of very, very friendly, says, "Hello, everyone. I hope you've had a good sleep these past several decades. You're probably wondering what's going on, why we've awoken you. The captain will be speaking to you all shortly. If you're looking for clothes, they'll be in the locker directly across from your cryopod. Does anyone have any urgent questions for me as of right now?" And he kind of looks around the room.
"You, robot thing, what's your name?"
"Hello, Doctor. Hello, Dr. Lloyd. I'm Reginald. I'm in charge of making sure the cryopods were safe. Probably won't have to be doing that now since we're approaching our goal." Yes, approaching is a good word for that.
Reginald, was it?
Yes.
How is the food storage right now? What is the status on that? Is it fine? Is it still sustainable? Is it
okay? You would have to talk to the chef about that. Unfortunately, being a robot, I don't consume much food. The chef did a very good job of making sure that the replicators were keeping the food storage in good supply, but unfortunately I don't have that knowledge right now. What I can tell you is that the bar is absolutely stocked to the brim. All that stuff should be in tip-top condition, so if you ever need any of that for your cooking, you should be completely fine.
Okay. Thank you very much for that information. I will go and see with the chef. Thank you.
Yes.
For cooking, I need a double.
No!
Any other questions from anybody? And this older man towards the back of the room kind of raises his hand and says, How long's it been? Feels like ages. And Reginald kind of stands up straight and says, "I'm glad you asked. I had that calculation running for the past, 68.179 years." The old man just kind of looks, okay. I'm surprised the ship is in this good of condition." And Reginald kind of brushes his jacket off and says, "Well, yes, I like to think that we've done a good job of keeping it in good shape for you guys. Any other questions from anybody?"
"You, robot boy, where's my office?"
This is a straight disrespect.
I don't actually know, sir. I'm sure the cryogenic haze will wear off and you'll remember where it is. And, if you ever need help, we're always happy to help. Unfortunately, I think it's on one of the upper decks. But again, I was in charge of maintaining cryopods, not cleaning your office, Doctor. My unfortunate
apologies. What are you even
good
for, then?
Why do you mean to the dude?
I keep these pods clean. I'm terribly sorry, sir. I didn't mean to annoy you. I will do my best to rectify the situation immediately." And he turns around to leave the room.
Bear, thank you.
Thank you for the reminder, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Bear.
Yes, your clothes are in the lockers in front of you. Goodbye. And he
thank you
leaves
so
the
much.
Room and walks
Thank you for
out.
Joining us. And thank you for the sub talk.
Oh,
you.
Fuck.
So, people are now starting to open their lockers. They're starting to pull out their uniforms. Some people pull out small trinkets that they've had in there. Someone's got a teddy bear. Someone's got a small deck of playing cards. Just, kind of things they wanted to have ready when they woke up. So what's in your guys' cubbies as you open them up?
So
is it starting out?
I guess I'll start out unless you wanted to.
No particular order. Whoever wants to go first can go first.
Then I guess I will. In my little cubby, besides obviously the suit, does the suit have a cutout for my tail, just so I know for comfortability issues?
That absolutely. For me?
Okay. But in my little cubby, it has a picture of my family from my home planet in there. It also has a which it is a sheathed in a special leather casing knife that has ingrained my initials on it. My original initials of my name from my home planet. And it is obviously sheathed and locked away. It is not of use, but it was more of just, I want to keep it with me near all times.
What's in your cubby?
Okay. Well, in my cubby, aside from the uniform, obviously, I have a bamboo flute that was passed down to me from my grandfather. I also have a satchel which has two shittily made daggers that I've had since I was young. Some lockpicking tools that we will get into later. And just a couple of random trinkets that have no monetary value.
All right. And Meme Lord, do you have anything in your cubby besides the uniform?
The whole DSM
guide. Wait, what?
The whole DSM guide.
No, I'm a doctor. I have it memorized. I have a black obsidian pen.
Ooh, nice.
Ooh. Fancy. It sounds expensive.
Damn.
All right. Well, as you guys put your uniforms on, you look around the room some more. It is in very good condition. Reginald did a phenomenal job of keeping this place clean. People start filing out the door. Eventually, you three are kind of the last ones left. Not by any fault of your own, just, you know, you guys were kind of the last ones to really wake up. And you put on your uniforms, and now, well, the world's your oyster. Apparently the captain's going to be giving a speech, but, you know, you don't have to go to that. You're crew members. You're sure you're going to, you can hear it from someone else. So what would you guys like to do?
Oh, I know where I'm
going. Go to the bar.
Well, of course you will. I'm going directly to the kitchen.
All right. Blue's going to the kitchen.
Got
to
cut some bacon. Wait, if we have
Where did bacon. You say you were going, Meme-Lord?
The bar.
The bar? Lovely. What about you, Spec?
I personally think I am actually going to go to the captain's speech, and then I'm going to hit the bar afterwards.
All right. We're going to do this in a very quick order then. Blue,
yes,
you arrive. Miller arrives at the kitchen. It is also in very good condition. What would you like to do? You can, looking around on a general glass, you can see that everything is in good shape, but that's about it. So what would you like to do here in the kitchen?
Do I have to do like any, like how in like normal, like RPG, is it like a perception or do I just, hey, like, how are this? How is this kind of things?
If you're saying like, how is this? There's a chance of failure. So we would roll.
Okay.
But because you're a chef, sorry, what was that?
I want to just check the condition of, especially how the fridge has been upkept, how the replicators have been upkept. I want to do like more of a wide sweeping like perception check.
Okay. Because you are a chef, I will let you use one additional die because you would know what the acceptable state of food is.
Okay. So two die.
Yes, and you're going to pick the higher number. Goodbye.
I got 2 threes.
Okay. So you look around. Unfortunately, it looks like Reginald might not have entirely known what the complete state of the kitchen is. So the replicators are fine. The rations are fine. The fridge within, you would say probably the last couple of years, has had a couple of wires just die. Like, oh, they've just stopped working. So it's cold. The robots haven't opened it. But it's not going to be cold for long, so you're going to want to make sure that gets looked at soon.
We're going to do the the mundane thing. All right, I have to go to technical support, get a ticket made. I have to go and find the who I assume is the ship's mechanic and ask if they can do it.
All right, yeah. So you're off doing that, Meme Lord. You arrive at the bar. It is slightly bustling. People are here. There's maybe like 3 or 4 other people in various places around the bar talking with each other, just sitting, having a drink. The bartender, who is also a robot, kind of slides up to you as you enter, says, "Hello, sir. What can I get for you tonight?"
"Whatever's free."
It's all free, sir. You're a member of the crew.
"Give me a double Jameson."
A double Jameson coming right up, and he slides behind the bar and he starts making it. "So, Dr. Lloyd, how did cryostasis treat you?"
"Terrible. Absolutely terrible.
I hate to hear
that." "It was cold, couldn't sleep."
"Oh, that's unfortunate. Well, let me tell you, my double Jameson will knock those bad memories right out of you. And he's just, he's like whirring through the motion super quick, like with the care of a master, just putting this together. And eventually he puts it on a coaster and slices it over to you. There you go, sir. Enjoy.
I space out and think, what memories?
No.
Love it.
I take it, take the drink in my hand, and then head to my office.
Lovely. All right.
Well, towards where they say my office is.
Love it. Spec, you arrive at the bridge of the ship, which is where the captain is going to be addressing most of the crew. And you head to your post, which is kind of in a little alcove at the back of the bridge. You've got your microphone, you've got your little, like, scripted notes of things that you'll want to talk about. And the captain walks over to you and says, "Hello, it's good to see you. Remind me your name. Cryostasis has not been kind to me in terms of names."
Valdeki Morthos.
Morthos, right.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, our morale officer. A loud, rambunctious one that had a bit too much to drink just before we went to sleep. I remember you. Right. Okay.
I remember the bad things.
So, here's the deal. I'm going to need you to make a broadcast. And he hands you a small index card. It's not super long. I'm going to need you to read this out in however you want. Just make sure that you hit everything that's on this card. And if you have any questions, feel free to let me know. And he hands you the card and he heads back to his post. And you take a look at the card. And it has four bullet points on it. And these are four bullet points that you will need to make sure that you hit if you want to obey the captain's orders. The first bullet point is that nothing bad happened to the cryo tubes. So that everyone who went to sleep in a cryo tube is now awake. Second bullet point. The ship is in perfectly functioning order, so everything is fine there. If there are any like technical problems, it's from minor disuse and it will be quickly fixed. Third bullet point. The sensors haven't picked up a planet yet, and the captain's not sure why you guys woke up yet, other than the AI found something that it thought was important. So the sensors are going to be scanning the area to try and keep an eye out on things. And the fourth bullet point is that whether or not you're a colonist or a crew member, you're going to have work to do on the ship for the next little while. So nobody gets to just sit around and lounge. So, do you need me to repeat any of those? Do you think you got a good idea?
I'm currently writing them down.
Hey, perfect. While you're writing them down, I'm going to go back to Meme Lord. You arrive at your office, or what you assume to be your office.
Hi, Scarlet.
It's got your nameplate on the door.
How are you? I hope you're having fun.
And
I hope you're having a good time.
You open the door, you walk in, and you find yourself in
tabletop.
A very, very, like, lush, resplendent office. It's got a carpet on the floor. It's got
bookshelves
that are full of books of various kinds, both fiction and nonfiction.
Yeah, it's fine. Sorry I didn't get to respond to your message.
A couch at one end opposite your desk. It's got a couple chairs. Your desk is made of a very nice mahogany.
Thank you for joining and chilling.
It's got a painting on the wall of two women in a field. This is unusually rich for even for a ship's psychologist.
So, is there a safe anywhere in this office? I know that?
Let's roll and see if you remember.
Okay, what do I need to roll?
Just roll one die and tell me what the result is.
Six.
Perfect. So you immediately get a skill in whatever it is you just did. So you roll to remember where the safe is. What would you like to make your skill be?
What options are there? Is there like a list?
The list is, what if you can convince me that the skill you just got would be applicable in this situation, I'll accept it. So it could be remembering, it could be finding things, it could be finding valuables.
Perception in general.
Yeah, exactly. Whatever you want.
Let's do perception in general, because,
Okay, yeah. So you remember, and your senses help a lot in this, that it's behind the painting, because the painting bulges out a little bit in the center. So if you pull down the painting, there will be a safe, and it will be kind of one of those where it reads your handprint, so no one can open it but you or someone who's mimicking your handprint. And you don't remember putting anything valuable inside of it, but that doesn't mean that you did. Or didn't.
I would like to open the safe.
Alright. As you open it, you find that there's one thing in it, and it's a piece of paper. It's folded very neatly, and it's got this, like, kind of matching with the tone of the room, it's got this big red stamp kind of sealing it together, much like you'd see in, like, you know, old 7th, 18th, 19th century movies where they're sending letters to each other. It's that kind of thing. It has your name on it, and no other name.
I'm gonna leave it there, but I also put my pen in it.
Alright. Anything else you would like to do in here?
Can I hop up and down on my chair like a child?
Absolutely. While you're doing that, I'm gonna jump back to...
Same.
I'm gonna jump back to Spec.
Hello. Spec.
The captain turns to you and says, "You ready to do the broadcast?"
I suppose so, but you know I'm not very good with script things.
It's okay. You just gotta make sure that those four bullet points get said. Reach them in whatever order you want, and you're golden. Alright. Ready whenever you are. You may begin your broadcast.
He nods and looks over his notes, as I'm doing right now.
Perfect.
Speaks on the microphone. Size. Hello. Hello, Starship Valiant crew members and colonists. So, you may be wondering why you are awake. Well, the AIs have found something, but there is not a planet in the sensors at the moment. But there is nothing to fear. The ship seems to be in perfect condition, and if there is anything seeming out of order, it is nothing much more than a quick fix. Please don't fret. Whether you're a colonist or a crew member, this is very important. Whether you are a colonist or a crew member, you will have to work. And there's not... You're not allowed to be lazy. There's no just lounging around. We all have to pick up our chair. Well, yes, some of us were hired on, you know, specifically to help around the ship. And some of us were just hired to colonize a new planet, or whatever. We all need to pool our share, and we cannot just rely on the crew members and the robots that are bound to break eventually. We must help out as well. But do not fear, nothing as bad has happened to the cryopods. And... Fuck. You've all been asleep too long. It's fine. We're all fine. Okay? Yeah. Don't be lazy. We're all fine. We're not dead yet. We're not dying. We're not under attack. We're all okay. The ship is good. We're not lost in space. And... That ends my broadcast. Goodbye.
Alright. As you finish your broadcast, the captain and Meme Lord and Blue, you two hear this broadcast over the speakers, wherever you're at. Spec, the captain turns to you and says, "Good job. I probably wouldn't have said that bit about the robots, but, I mean, you've got a certain way with words, and I can't control that. You're free to go to your quarters for the time being. I'll call you back up when we've got more information for you to relay."
Oh, do you want to come with me?
I must stay at my post, unfortunately.
Unfortunately. Wow.
I love it. Sorry.
Alright. Spec, while you're heading back to your office or attempting to flirt with the captain, Blue,
Yes.
You find yourself in a hallway. So, Specs broadcast has just ended. You know, kind of. So there's some good, there's some bad, there's some you're not really sure how to feel about it. And you find yourself in an empty corridor. There's metal on the sides of the walls. There's a couple of, like, little alcoves that have, like, you know, potted plants or, like, a picture, or maybe there's, like, a TV screen that's broadcasting kind of a text to, or a speech to text, whatever the fetch those are called. Subtitles.
Yes.
The subtitles of Specs broadcast. But other than that, there's not really anything down here. And while you're walking, I would like you to roll your do anything skill.
Okay, so that's just a regular d6?
Yes.
Alright. A 6.
Perfect. So,
thank you for the hydrate.
You are going to get a skill in something related to hearing something. Not necessarily listening for it, but hearing it. So you can go down kind of the path Meme Lord did with perception. You can go hearing things, whatever, picking up vibrations, whatever you want to do. You have sensed something.
Hmm.
And that something is big.
Oh.
And it is heavy.
Okay.
And you, like, you've kind of felt the other robots. They're not this heavy, or at least if they are this heavy, they're not this thunk about it.
Oh, okay.
And as you round a corner, you see a robot. But it's not one of the crew robots. It's, well, for one thing, it's got this big red dot on your forehead.
Oh.
On its forehead. It's got a big red dot on its forehead. Okay. The second thing is, as you round the corner and it sees you, it starts charging at you, kind of like a bull. What do you do?
No, it has not sensed me. It has not sensed my presence, correct?
It saw you.
Oh, it saw me.
You rounded a corner, it saw you, it's now charging at you.
Oh, the only thing I could really think to do would honestly be to go back in, like, go back the corner I was and book it.
Okay. Like,
start running the opposite fucking way, because I don't know if it's good. I don't know if it's actually, like just curious or, like, going to, like, run up to me really quickly and assist me. I don't know what's going to happen, and I don't know what to expect from it, you know? So I'm going to run the opposite way.
Okay. As you run the opposite way, actually, go ahead and make another skill check this time. And do you feel like your character is anxious at this moment?
It's scared, so yes. He is scared.
Okay. I'm going to then roll your clumsiness against you.
Okay.
So I'm going to roll an extra die. So go ahead and make a roll.
All right, I did.
What did you get?
I got a 4.
Okay. As you round the corner, it catches up to you.
Okay.
It's fast. Like, something this big and heavy should not be this fast, and yet it is. And it rounds the corner, and it comes, like, right behind you, and just as it's about to hit you, it vanishes.
What?
Like, straight up just is gone.
Like magician.
Like, there's no sound effect, nothing. It's just, like, 1 second, it's about to hit you, the next second, nothing.
Oh, okay. I'm not gonna roll for this, but I'm gonna collapse to the ground real quick.
Okay.
I want to roll fine. To not shit my pants.
Yeah.
Roll. Go ahead.
I rolled a 1.
Shit.
No.
You
don't necessarily. Your pants are not necessarily soiled, but you definitely have a moment on the floor, and it is not pretty.
Ooh, start crying and shit.
Yeah, you're. You have come very close to being seriously injured by something that was not expected, and you're not sure how to process that besides having an anxious breakdown.
Am I nearby to hear this?
Roll, let's see.
I'm definitely gonna have a new client.
And I'll let you roll your perception die.
So if it's a skill I have, I get an extra 6, right? And then I take the higher of the two?
Yes.
Okay. Haha, see, I'm learning things. And it's a 6!
Wait.
Alright, so because you were using this with your perception skill, you immediately get a level 3 skill in something related to hearing things.
Can I do empathy?
Why would that be applicable to just hearing someone cry?
Because I'm assuming it's a spaceship and it's kind of loud, so I'm distinctly hearing crying.
Oh, and like detecting that it's someone crying, rather than just hearing a noise and being like, sure, you know what? I will give you that. You have empathy 3.
Dope.
Okay. So, you hear someone crying. It sounds maybe like one of the other crew members and not a robot. But you can't really make out who it would be. The voice isn't registering in your mind for you, but it's close to your office. Like, it's close enough that you could probably get there within, like, 2-3 minutes if you booked it from your office.
Do I have medication in my office? I am a psychiatrist.
Okay, yeah, roll an extra... Roll 2 dice, since you are a psychiatrist, and you'll get an extra die for that.
4.
Yeah. You totally have the needed medications on hand.
Okay, I have a syringe of anti-anxiety medication. I run out into the hallway looking for whomever. Because I don't know what's going on. I don't know if somebody's like having a fight or what's happening. Just somebody is screaming and I can hear it over the clanging of the ship.
Okay. Yeah, so you're just booking it. Miller, you suddenly, as you're having kind of this anxiety breakdown, you hear someone just booking it around the corner. And they come around, and it's the captain, or not the captain, sorry, the psychologist, Dr. Lloyd. And he rounds the corner, and he's got something in his hand, and he bends down. And what happens, Meme Lord?
Are you okay? What's happening?
I don't really have, like, I can barely even speak, I think. Like, at this point, I'm just so terrified of, like, I'll be, like, more muttering, like... Big, like, amongst crying, just big robot running, gone!
Ah! From this, like, I make an assumption he's having an anxiety reaction from the cryo chamber, so I administered the medication that I brought.
Okay.
Do we need to, like, roll to see if he resists this or kind of any issue? Because, I mean, I am just straight up injecting him with something.
I'm going to say for this one that it just works.
And like, I would probably be more of like so out of it that I don't even notice you hit me with anything. I'm just like so freaked out.
Yeah, it hits your bloodstream and you feel like an injection, but it's not like you're so out of it that you barely even register that you're being poked. But then something starts flowing through your veins and you feel your body calming down a little bit to the point where you're able to take a couple of good deep breaths. And then eventually, like, the anxiety is still there. It's not gone away, but it's not at the level of, holy crap, I'm having a panic attack.
All right, so it basically just put me back to a little bit of even.
Yeah.
All right. So
at this point, I'm not even waiting for him to, like, recover. I'm literally just picking him up and dragging him. I don't know if I can actually pick him up because he's an alien, but I'm, like, trying to
force him up. You're helping him back to your office, is what you're doing.
Yep.
Okay, perfect. Well, as you're doing that, Spec, we're gonna cut to you.
Hello.
So you're heading back to your quarters, and as you're doing so, could I get you to make a check as well, a skill check? Just roll 1 dice for this one.
D6, right?
Yes.
I got a 6.
Okay. You also get a skill in perception.
Oh dear.
You three are very good at noticing things.
Yes,
yes, we
are.
I don't know how to feel about this. So
I'm a bard, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
You round the corner and you hear something. It's coming from maybe like, I don't know, a couple of meters away. It sounds big and it sounds heavy. it sounds mechanical as well, which is a weird bit of mental dissonance for you, because as far as you know, none of the robots on this ship are this big or this loud. And as you walk a bit farther, you see a robot up ahead of you. Its back is turned to you, and it's big. It's bigger than what you thought the robots on the ship were cleared to be. But then again, you're not in charge of bots, so I guess anything's possible. And as you walk towards it, it suddenly stops, like, kind of stiffens, turns around to face you, and you notice it's got a big red dot on its forehead. And it turns around, sees you, and then is just gone. Like, one moment it's there, and the next it's just not there. Like, the space where it existed is empty. And then everything's quiet again. No clanking, just the whir of the starship.
That is disturbing, and I do not like that.
So, what do you do?
I'm gonna look around a bit.
Okay.
See if
Go
I can
ahead read. And make a perception check. Roll 2d6 and take the higher result.
Okay. The higher result was 5.
You find on the floor these weird scuff marks. The floor is made of a very, like, hardened steel. And there's these very faint scuff marks in it, like someone kicked the back of their foot. They kicked their heel into the floor very hard. And that's all you can really find.
I suppose after that, I would probably try to find Blue or go back to my chambers. Or okay. John?
What would you rather do in this instance? What would your character prefer to do? Because you were going to your chambers already. So, would you go straight to your chambers, or would you go looking for the chef? Which would make more sense?
I would go looking for the chef, so I could see if they have seen anything about it.
Okay.
Because, you know.
Why the chef? What interactions have your character and Miller had before this?
It's not necessarily, you know, it's Miller, it's oh yay food, it's they're also not human as I am, so...
Ah, so kind of that common bond of being unnormal. Okay, sure. So yeah, you go looking for Blue, and while you're searching around the ship for Blue, Meme Lord, Lloyd has brought Miller back to the office, has kind of laid Miller somewhere in the office, be it on a chair or on the couch. And now you've got this cat alien who was having a panic attack, who's calmed down, and who is blabbering something about a big robot. What do you do?
I lean back in my very plush new chair, because I'm assuming it's all new. I get my little notepad, and I start asking him questions. How are you? What are you feeling? Are you feeling okay? Because at this point, I think it's just a medical issue. He's having some weird psychiatric response to being in cryosleep for so long. I don't think he's actually, responding to a crisis.
Okay. Why don't you two act that scene out? It can just be for, a couple of questions. But what kind of questions are you asking? And Blue, what are your answers to those questions?
So what was the first one? Because it's more of just to get into character.
Mm-hmm.
So, what are you feeling?
I feel a lot better than I was a few minutes ago. I'm panicked, man. I don't know what the fuck I saw.
Okay. Take a deep breath for me. 10 seconds in, hold, and then release for 10 seconds, okay? At the same time, I start talking to him, prepping him for the next question. I said, okay, what's his name? I'm sorry, Miller? Is it?
Yeah, yes. Miller, yes.
Miller, can you tell me from the time that you got out of the cryopod what you did, when, and where, and then what led you to having a panic attack in the hallway?
Okay. I got out the cryopod. I went to go and check on my belongings and the thing. I put on the suit. I immediately went to the kitchen because that is my domain after all. I wanted to check to make sure everything was a-okay, right? I wanted to make sure everything was all good. I had to go and check the fridge. The fridge needed fixing. So I went to go to the maintenance person, and I heard the announcement for, the morale officer or DJ put on the thing, which I thought was pretty good. I liked it, you know. So I walked down the hall. As I was walking down the hall listening to that, I saw something that shouldn't have been saw. I don't think it should have been like that. It was a giant freaking robot, man. It was just standing down the hall. It turned towards me as soon as I turned the corner, dude. And then it looked at me with a big, like, it had a big, like, glowing, like, red dot on its, like, head. But it was, like, 2 to 3 times bigger than the normal robots, like Ferdinand. It was, like, that big, like, huge. It saw me and ran after me. And after that, I just lost peace. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's happening. Like, we got a drop in raid from our Haru. Hello, Ducky Yardy. Hello, thank you for the raid. Thank you for joining our RPG section. Hello Raiders. Hello, Haru. Thank you. Thank you for joining. We're not far in, but we're enough where I already had a panic attack. Not me, but my character.
This is very fun so far.
Yes, I really like this so far. Anyway, so back in session. Thank you again, Haru. I saw this giant robot. It started running at me, and then it was really fast. It was like it was insane. It kept running, and then it disappeared, and that's when I blacked out. And then I woke up like basically here. I don't know what it was. I don't know what it was. I don't know how something could run that fast and disappear behind me. I don't know. I don't know what's happening.
It's okay. You're safe. My door is locked.
Okay.
Do you think that it could have been a large vacuum cleaner machine running?
There's no way something like that could have been a vacuum machine. There was no sound coming from it besides the giant footsteps running behind me. I did not hear anything. And I'm good at picking up like sounds like that. I didn't hear anything coming from it besides thunk, 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 and then faster thunks, and then it was right behind me, and I thought I was gonna fucking die.
Okay, Miller.
And then it went away.
I gotta stop reading chat.
Thank you, Ducky. Thank you.
This may just be a psychological response to you being asleep for so long. It is a significant amount of time that we've been locked away, and your brain just still might be adapting to reality. Okay. When was the last time you ate?
I went to the replicator. I grabbed some of the nearest plants there because I prefer plant food. So I grabbed the nearest thing. I tried to replicate some celery. I had some of that. And then whatever dried beef we had, I had a little bit of that, just so I could taste for the properties to see if it was still edible, right? I had some of that, and I just let myself chill, trying to figure out the situation with the fridge. That was all that I had, as I woke up. It was something, at least, more than I was able to, before I could even make anything for anyone else, just to check the quality.
Okay, Miller. We're going to go back to your room. You're going to be on medical leave for a few days. I want you to get sleep, recover, reset, and then we'll retouch base in a few days, okay? I'll walk you back to your room so you're safe, so nothing happens. Okay. But everything is going to be okay from now on.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Right. So I assume you're going back to your room now?
Yeah.
I walk with him.
All right. Spec. You arrive at the kitchen area.
Yeah,
and
I'm sorry,
Miller's not there. You don't know where Miller is.
I had to turn off the thing just because of the voice replay. It will be back on Monday, and you can save up and then torch me with it, okay? And you can play with us, okay? On Monday,
like
if you want to do collab streaming.
Is there anything
even?
You would like to do here in the kitchen? Would
I will
like
do.
Just keep looking for Miller.
Are there still robots and other members of the staff or colonists in the kitchen itself?
Doing it so I won't be in voice chat on Monday, but we can definitely play together if you want.
I'm doing ASMR. Not, but there
doing
is
my best
evidence that there have been people in here recently.
Yeah. But yeah, on Monday I'll have
I would like
the
to step outside
for the
kitchen and ask the nearest person if they have seen a cat boy running around the ship.
I will collab eventually. Probably not on Monday. Probably not on Monday just because I'm doing the ASMR.
I'm not sure what you're talking about. If you're talking about the chef, I haven't seen.
But I want to do an I would like to do a collab with you. We could do a dual stream. I would love to do that.
This is hard.
I would like to do it with a couple people.
I see. Thank you anyways.
Especially fellow like VTubers.
And then I just step away I look around.
Alright.
But we'll talk about it. It might not be this Monday.
Sorry,
but next
go ahead.
Monday maybe.
Is there anybody else nearby besides that dude?
It's because you're cool, Haru. I love watching your streams and stuff. You're very entertaining.
There are a couple, but none of them are interested in talking right now. They're all busy with maintenance on the ship.
That's what I.
Okay.
You know, not this Monday because that's ASMR stream, but I will be playing with everyone.
Anything else you'd like to do?
And Discord doesn't like to pick up my ASMR.
I would like to try to head back to my room so I can think it over of to where. Mr.
But definitely probably
Catboy
next one.
Might be.
Yeah.
Hey. Yeah, you head back to your room.
And you can even
as you're heading back
to
your room,
see if
it just so happens that your room and Miller's room
Zink
are
awesome
pretty
desk.
Close to each other.
You're awesome. Desk.
So as you're coming
Everyone's
back
awesome
to your
desk.
Room, you notice the shrink, the ship shrink. Lloyd, that's his name. Kind of leading Miller back to his room. Miller looks a little shaken. Not super crazy bad, but definitely enough to be noticeable.
I would like to approach them.
All right. Miller and Lloyd. You notice that the morale officer is coming. Spec, I'm so sorry. What is your character's name again?
Pildecky Morthos.
Morthos. I don't know why I keep forgetting Morthos.
I thought it was Mordos at the first time, and then I had to recorrect it. Morthos.
Yeah, so
Morthos.
You notice Morthos kind of rounding the corner.
Morty.
Sees you two, comes over, seems
like... back on the call.
He wants to know what's going on.
Whatever.
No, I was just saying you weren't on the screen.
Oh. Yes. There we go. So yeah. What do you guys do? You see that this person is coming.
Oh shit.
That
Maymord.
The morale officer is
Thank
coming.
Thank you. Thank you for giving it to the Haru.
And I still on the board walking with Miller to his room.
Yes.
Hey, what's up? You seem to be in a hurry.
I turn towards Lloyd and I shake my head, gesturing my hand towards Miller. I would like to speak to him if that is all right.
Miller, that's up to you. You've had a pretty rough day, bud.
That depends on the nature. Oh wait, I wasn't doing the voice right. Let me repeat that. That depends on the nature that you are kind of speaking on. What was it? What was the matter? What's up?
I turn towards Lloyd. I look between him and Miller. Then I just sigh. Have you by chance seen... Oh dear, how do I put this? A very large vacuum cleaner.
Wait. So, you've seen something, but what I saw I saw something large. How would you describe it? What is the main, like, How would you describe this thing?
Oh, dear. Large, heavy, very sturdy, made out of metal. It was a robot. It was... had a red dot between its head.
Okay. No, I can stop you there. So, did it run at you in any form? Was it, like, stomping at you in any form? Did it disappear?
It disappeared out of nowhere. It just vanished, like my father.
Oh. Sorry about your dad.
It's fine.
Gives you a pat on the back. Where was... like, where did you see this? Or was it in a hallway? Was it... where was it?
I don't remember. It was in the ship. It was... I think it was in the hallway, but it left scuff marks. It was definitely there. I'm not insane.
Talker?
But, I don't know what to say anymore. It was there. Then it wasn't. But I know it was there because it left marks. But then it wasn't there. But there was evidence. You know what I'm talking about, right?
Yes. Dr. Lloyd.
Yes.
This is up to your discretion, obviously, because you are the doctor here. Can we go and check out those scratches? Or should I just rest? It's up to your best judgment of better for me, I guess. I think this is a clue that it might prove that I am not just seeing things.
Well, normally I would say we need to address the AI boy, whatever he is. I don't like them. But I think they might be in cahoots. I think we need to go talk to if there's a security officer and then the captain to address this issue.
Should we investigate the scratches first, like by ourselves, just so we have evidence, just so we can confirm what Morthos is saying? Was it Morthos, right?
Yep.
All right, what Morthos is saying.
Sure. But I wouldn't go too far, especially if this thing chased after you.
Yes. Well, I would probably say, I would probably stand back and then, you know, if you could look, you know, that would be nice. You know. The thing ran after me, so, you know, I don't know. It's up to you guys.
Yeah, let's go take a look at it. Morthos, yes?
Yes. It's Morthos.
Can you lead us back to where you saw these scratches?
Yes, I suppose so. I suppose now we are retracing my steps, not ours, my steps, to back where the scuff marks were.
All right. Well, as you retrace your steps, as you round the corner back to where you saw the scuff marks, you notice that there's a member of the cleaning crew there, kind of, you know, on his hands and knees, furiously scrubbing at an area of the deck. And as you come closer, you realize he's furiously scrubbing at the scuff marks, trying to get them out, and they're just not coming out.
Who's scrubbing? Huh?
What do you guys want?
What are these scratches from?
I don't know, they just showed up. I was on my route trying to clean the walls, and I see these, and if the captain sees them, he's going to have an aneurysm.
I think you need to stop. That might be caused by a rogue robot that's attacking people.
A rogue? What?
A rogue bot.
I was going to...
Are you crazy? You realize that the robots have strict programming, right?
Well, I have two people here that were attacked. And I was witness to the one person being pushed down onto the ground.
Look, I wasn't attacked. Don't lump me in with him.
Oh, I'm not good enough.
I don't know anything about the bots on the ship. If you want to ask someone about the bots, you're going to want to talk to Grigor.
Where can we find Grigor?
He's on the lower deck. Just go to the engineering area, ask for Grigor. You should be able to find him there. Gotta clean these stupid scuff marks up, or my boss is gonna have my paycheck.
Good luck.
I believe
it. Thanks. All right. You guys want to do anything else there, or are you guys just gonna head for the lower deck area?
Wait, do I have any like picture equipment? Like, do I have a device on me that allows me to take a picture or something?
Let's roll for shoes.
All right.
Just a single die will work.
I got a 3.
You have a very primitive holo camera. It's not going to be able to take a perfect picture of it, but it should work fine enough.
I'll ask the cleaner dude if I can just take a picture of the thing just so I have it for the reasoning of pointing it out to Griggle.
Fine, I guess you can, but I promise you, if you show that to the captain, I will do things to you you will not like. I need to have these scuff marks out.
I promise you I won't do anything for that. That's just for showing Griggle.
Thank you.
Look, if the captain gets on your head, just call me.
Scrubbing as hard as he can.
Wait, so Spec, is your character almost like the second in command-ish? Almost?
Even
higher on the tier
that's
list?
That's actually... That would be interesting, but I mean, that's honestly just so up to Nightwing.
Yeah, so it's like you're the maybe the speaker of
that. You're the morale officer, so I don't know if I would call you the second in command, but you're definitely high up on the command chain, because your job is to make sure everyone is happy.
Then me over here just being head chef. I have
Chef
Weirdy. I'm Chef Weirdy. Cat version.
Okay. Yes, I'm here to make everybody happy, and sometimes happiness entails fading into blackness. Okay.
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 Yes.
Fade to black. We fade to black to the whatchamadoodle. We fade to black to the engineering area. You guys walk in. Someone walks up to you. Hello. How can I help you?
Oh dear, am I taking lead? Okay.
Yeah, go for it.
You guys here to waste my time or?
No, we're not.
Okay, well, what's up?
Oh, Griggle. Griggle? That's his name? Yes.
Hey, Griggle! Couple of guys here looking for you. Griggle kind of sits up. He's a big, burly guy, dressed in a very like plain red uniform to signify that he's a mechanic. Kind of lumbers over to you guys, muttering under his breath.
Oh,
hello, what you want?
Hello.
You're making fun of my accent.
No, I was saying that character. I was just. It was funny. I'm sorry. But no. So, I have a question for you, sir. I assume you help with working the robots, correct? You work with
yes,
all this.
Yes, I am in charge of keeping robots in good condition.
So, what size robots would be big, have a red dot in the middle of their forehead, and possibly roam the halls?
You don't want to talk to me, friend. I only maintain robots. I don't know what they like. If you have a question like that, you want to talk to Anthony.
To Anthony? Does he handle, like, programming?
He is an official keeper of bots. He keeps bots in check. I can take you to where he is. He is not far from here.
Okay. I would very much appreciate.
Okay, follow me. And he kind of lumbers out the door. Yells back, someone take care of bot, prepare for me beat for beat, and someone's like, you got it, sir, and runs over to where Griggle was, and Griggle lumbers down the hallway towards another door.
Turns Wait, did you corner. Say did you say give robot a beat?
No.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Somebody repair work, somebody take over
somebody,
Grigor's repair
yeah,
job.
Yeah, take over repairs.
Okay,
yeah.
I thought you were making more Russian jokes, and I was like, no, not the beats.
No. So, Grigor lumbers in the hallway, lumbers into a door. Anthony, I got 3 people here want to talk to you about robots. Lumbers out, motions you guys in, and lumbers back to the engineering area. And Anthony is a tall guy, very skinny, wears glasses. Kind of, he's working on writing something, sketching something out. Looks up, sees you guys, looks back down at his work. Yes, what do you guys want?
I'll go with them. Do you got this, or do you want me to handle?
You can do it if you would like.
Okay. So, what I mentioned to Grigor was, one, hold, I pull out my phone. What robot would make tracks like these?
That would be a big one.
All right. So, which one of the robots that work on the ship is I would say larger size per se, has a red flashing, like a red dot on its head, and can move quite fast for its weight?
You sure about that red dot?
I am 100%.
Because that usually signifies a decommissioned bot. Those aren't allowed on official UEA ships, of which the Valiant is proudly one.
Okay. That even furthers my worry. So, as you may or may not know, I am the chef here. I went to go to check out something involving the fridge problem, because our fridge needs fixing, just in case, someone who's the best at it, if you could fix it or someone else could, that would be nice. Anyway,
just there.
Thank you. I was out looking, going there when I heard the announcement about our current position after getting out of the cryopods. I went down one of the tunnels, one of the hallways. I turned the corner and saw this exact bot standing around, I would say 40 to 50. Was he 40? I'm asking on character, 40, 50 meters, something?
Just like it was close enough to you that you could see the red dot. So okay. Probably more like 10, 20 meters 10, 20. Away.
Oh, I was thinking it was like a glowing. So I would probably see from...
No, probably. It's like someone painted it's like a 30 red feet away. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So like, around 30, I would say 30 feet away. So around 10, 20 meters away from me. I saw the bot. It turned to me. I saw exclusively a red dot in the middle of its forehead. It was about 2 to 3 times bigger than the normal robots, especially like the Fernando that we saw when we first came in.
Ferdinand? I believe you're talking about Reginald.
Reginald. Why did I get those mixed up? Reginald. Mm. That one. Reginald. That was there. It's around 2 to 3 size bigger, and it had a red dot on its head, and it started to charge towards me. When it got around like a few feet behind me, it just disappeared, leaving me scared. And my friend over here, Morthos, also saw this robot, and I have the picture of the tread marks as point of it was there at one point.
So I can't argue with tread mark evidence, but look, Miller, I'm not a psychologist. That's Lloyd's job. But you sure you're not a little shaken from cryostasis? I mean, aliens do tend to have a bit of a harder time readjusting than us humans.
Well, so both of them are different races. And generally, races are going to have much different reactions. So the fact that they're describing the same thing without confirming it to each other verifies that to some degree there's some kind of weird robot walking around. Whether or not it's rogue or it's decommissioned or whatever, something odd is happening.
Sure, but here's the thing. Morthos, did the bot attack you?
Well, no, not really. It's just, it looked at me. It was a bot, so it obviously had no aggression in its not real eyes, and vanished.
So, here's the thing. Bots sometimes have a tendency to release nanite particles. Those nanite particles sometimes like to gather, and if inhaled can cause hallucinations. So, I mean, I don't know for certain what caused the tread marks, but I'm sure something did. I'm sure it's nothing to worry about. I'm sure you two just got some nanites, and it was a coincidence that you two hallucinated the same thing. You probably saw rogue bots, decommissioned bots back at the space dock. I'm sure it's nothing to worry about.
I do have a question, then.
Yeah?
So, if we go to the... Just to make sure, just cut out any possibility that maybe something is going wrong, even if it's, rogue not, whatever. Make sure everything is in check, everyone is safe in terms of safety of the whole colony, is that I will go to the security officer. Go there, get tapes or get some evidence that maybe, you know, we weren't just seeing stuff, and then bring it to you. Would you be able to give us, like, would you be able to possibly turn to more information or being another helper and figure out what the fuck is going on?
Miller, you can give me all the evidence you want. All our bots are here. And he gestures over towards the other side of the room, and you just see, like, a bunch of bots were sleeping. Sometimes bots are waking up and going elsewhere. They're all here. Like, I can track each and every one of these guys' signals from my desk here. None of them have done anything out of the ordinary. If they had, it would alert me to something, and that hasn't happened. So, professionally, do whatever you need to. I'm not going to believe you. Personally, if you saw something like that, I might even consider going to talk to the shipping crew. Maybe they saw something. I don't know. Again, this is off the record. Like,
understand.
Don't tell anyone I told you this, but go talk to the shipping crew. Maybe something got let loose that shouldn't have been let loose. I don't know.
All right. Understandable. Thank you very much for listening out our talks. Thank you.
Sure.
Do you happen to have a tracker of any kind for these robots? A spare one, even if it's like a previous model?
Look, mate. Lloyd, doctor, doc. I'm the bot keeper. That's my job. If I were to give that job to someone else, even if I'm still doing it, that is a massive liability, yada, yada, yada. So unfortunately, I can't let you do that.
Don't tell anyone I told you. Proceeds to
all right, I will send you the bill for the medication that I administer then. Thanks.
Look, I'm trying
Thank you, Captain. That's awesome. Hello, Captain.
That is a huge liability for the crew. These bots are not going to be monitored.
Thank you.
You don't want to do that.
I'm saying for the crew that I have to treat because there's some wild-ass bot walking around.
Look, do what you need to. I promise you the bot is not one of mine.
Bruce Force.
Now can I please get back to my schematics?
Continue on.
And he gets back and he starts sketching again.
So Captain, this is
anything else you guys would like to do here?
Homebrewed game by Nightwing. It's
can
not
I
D&D,
look over
it's a tabletop
his
RPG.
Schematics.
It is
yeah,
meant
sure.
for it's a space based we're on
it's
a
nothing out of the ordinary. It's just
space
he's sketching up some
station
design for like
ship with
Colony.
Colony, I think you'd like
it.
Kind of Star Trek-y.
It's probably for scouting planets.
There's only two races of aliens as of right now.
Can I look to see
me
if there happens
and,
to be a
Spax
tracker,
which is basically a tiefling-like
Lloyd
race.
Put it, anywhere
I am a cat race.
In reach.
Roll for shoes using your perception skill.
Yeah, so we're playing. So far, we saw a giant robot, maybe a rogue one, maybe hallucination.
Well, I also got a five,
maybe another
that
alien that can shape shift.
Ties.
We don't know.
Uh-huh.
We're finding it out.
So,
damn.
You see it. It's within
reach. I'm the
reach,
first one that saw it and almost killed
but
me.
But also, like, Anthony has his hand pretty close to it.
You're doing fun as a doctor. You're very serious. Like, I'm in your face, doctor.
He's watching you guys out of the corner of his eye. Like you it. Can tell. So, you could probably steal it, but there would be repercussions.
Gotcha.
All right.
I'm just gonna walk away then.
Sounds good.
Man, I doubt the captain would accept my bedroom offer if I was in trouble.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Well then.
Being a bad boy just steals it. How'd you know? You didn't say
anything
you.
Else you guys want to do here, or are you gonna move out?
Is there like a bot tracker just laying around somewhere? Like,
that's
out?
What Spec just did.
Yeah.
Oh, why Spec... am I not hearing things today?
Well, you are a little
it's all
bit
good.
Off, yeah. Because of stuff.
So,
reason.
Yeah, there is a tracker. It's on the desk. It's by Anthony's hand. If you took it, Anthony would notice and there would be repercussions.
Yeah, I'm personally with the whole I'm fine with getting out of here. He's given us some information of kind of looking not fully the other way, but looking a little bit the other way.
Mm-hmm.
We'll leave it for now.
Yeah.
All right.
Because if I have evidence, he said professionally, he won't pursue it.
Yep.
Well,
but
professionally, he's being a twat.
Well, he kind of has to be. He kind of has to be serious about it, but personally, he's like, hey, like, here's some hints, and maybe... So...
Yeah.
Professionally, right, it's this shit. Anyway. So where do you guys, do you want to go to the security to check maybe the thing to make sure, you know, everything's like what we're seeing isn't just maybe hallucinogens? Or do you want to each like split up and talk to like group? Like, I don't know, it's up to you.
I would prefer staying together.
Okay, so we can go to the security personnel head and see if we can, if they can check the tapes, or if we can see the tapes from earlier today, like an hour ago.
That sounds good.
I think that would probably be the best. I don't think they would have anything bad if, as long as we're not getting two, because we literally just woke up, not even like a couple hours ago. So, I would say that. What do you think? What do you both think?
Sounds good to me. I'm just happy to walk around.
Phenomenal.
Oh, you're just happy to walk around, stretch your legs.
So you guys are going to the security office?
I'm happy to talk to anyone. Hopefully this this security person is nice.
Okay. Especially he ain't do nothing.
Well, you guys walk into the security area, and there is someone there, but they are currently... They've got headphones on, and they're monitoring something. So they don't hear you when you guys come in.
What's on the monitor, can I see?
It is a view of one of the ship's hallways. You can't really quite make out what it is without like looking super closely, but it's one of the ship's hallways.
Okay. Is there anything in the hallway, or we just can kind of just see the hallway?
If you want to see what's in the hallway, you would have to look closer.
Which okay. Can I just walk up behind him? I mean, I don't really care.
Yeah. Go ahead and make a perception check.
That's two. Four.
Okay. You notice that there is... So it's the hallway that you guys were in with the custodian who was scrubbing the treadmarks. Except that he's no longer there. The treadmarks are still there. So it looks like he just gave up and resigned himself to his fate. But the security officer is apparently monitoring this area quite intensely for some reason.
I walk up to him and I kind of poke him on the shoulder.
The security officer turns around. You realize that it's a girl.
Oh.
And she looks at you. Yeah, what can I do for you?
Hi, ma'am. I don't mean to pry, but we were in that hallway and there was an incident. I was
Dr.
wondering
Lloyd,
if you know...
Something wrong?
There was a large robot seen, and that large robot was also seen in another hallway chasing down another crew member. So we were kind of coming to ask you to see if you knew anything about that, or if there's any kind of footage or evidence of what had happened.
So, I heard something. I've been kind of monitoring the ship for a little bit. In fact, she looks at the clock. It's going to be time for me to get off soon.
Oh, it is.
I can probably... Here's the thing. Someone in the shipping area alerted me to some weird sounds that were coming, so I decided to do a monitor.
You're doing some
walks. And I was monitoring the area, and this hallway got brought up as it had some loud sounds, but when I got to it, I didn't really see anything. I actually saw you three come up and talk to the dude, the custodian person. But that's about it.
I can't really be. Did the custodian walk away?
Yeah, he was scrubbing for a while, and then someone else came along, and they were talking with each other, and then the custodian dude just kind of picked up his stuff and left with the other person.
Okay.
So, you're saying everything, before the custodian started cleaning, there's nothing really that was of event.
What do you mean by that?
Like, did you see anything weird in the hallway with that the custodian was in prior to the custodian?
Really. No, not really. Just there were some unusually loud sounds there, kind of matched the level what the shipping department was reporting. That's about it, though.
Wait, the shipping department?
Yeah, the shipping area was reporting some loud sounds. That's why I was monitoring this area.
Okay.
What about the area closer to my hallway? Where Miller where he feel he was attacked.
Miller was attacked?
He was threatened by the robot and then chased down, and then the robot maybe gave up or ran away or kind of disappeared.
Yeah. Kind of just Oof.
I mean, I can look. I didn't see anything about it being brought up, which is weird, because if, you know, there's an attack, that would probably be a loud sound level, but it didn't even get brought up to me. So, I mean, I can look for you quick if you want.
Yes, please.
All right. She swings around, kind of types some stuff in, the monitor flashes to that hallway, and she does some stuff, and it flashes back to... You, Miller, you see yourself on the screen walking down the hallway, and then the robot comes around the corner. And all four of you jump at the same time as it charges and then vanishes.
Wow.
And
Christ.
The security officer kind of pulls her headphones down, kind of. Okay. Have you already talked to Anthony?
Yes.
We did. He kind of professionally blew us off.
Yeah, he said I can't
Sounds
really
like
do anything with it.
Sounds like Anthony. Look, you guys should probably go check with the shipping department. If this bot isn't one of ours, they might know something about it. I need to show this to Anthony and the captain. And she kind of hurriedly like downloads something onto a portable computer she has on her arm and kind of just books it out of the room.
Okay. Thank you very much. And then she runs.
Yeah.
She flies.
I'm gonna turn towards Miller and Lloyd. Should one of us perhaps go after her?
Should we?
That's a good question though. Because especially if there's a rogue robot, who's to say that she is safe while on the way to deliver that stuff? And the robot won't go after her and actually take her down.
Okay, so I'm going to be a little bit of a scumlord here. Is there any kind of, like, anti-robot devices in there? Or a weapon that I could kind of conceal?
She in the security area?
Yeah, she kind of just left us in there.
Roll for shoes. Guess.
This Roll doctor your is perception. Not playing nothing. This doctor is The doctor's not playing no easy bet.
Five.
You can see weapons, but they are locked with the same kind of handprint lock that your safe has.
I want to try it.
Okay. Go ahead and roll.
Needs a taser, bro.
Roll just one die.
Okay.
Dice die.
Three.
You put your hand on it, and it scans your hand, and then it goes, eh. Handprint not recognized.
Morale person. I'm sorry, I keep forgetting your name. Can you check
Morthos.
This? You are Morthos, that's right. You are an officer. You should have some level of discretion to access security equipment. You wanna give it a shot? Oh. Hold on, the spec's having issues here.
Well, that's a problem.
That's a problem. That's a big no. It just Hold muted.
On. I'm gonna just take spec out real quick and then put it.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, can you hear us now?
Apologies, spec? Chat.
Spec's not in our.
Difficult.
So spec's not.
Yeah. I gotta invite spec to speak and then spec can. There we go. Spec can hear us. Hey.
There we go.
Yes, everything's good now.
We're good. All right. Yeah.
So,
Morthos, can you put your hand on the lock? You are an officer, so you should have access to some degree of security equipment.
Would I be able to?
You're an officer.
Well, I am, but I'm not that kind of officer.
Well, you still have more authority than us. You do report directly to the captain.
I suppose you're correct. I suppose I step over and place my hand directly onto the lock pad.
Hey, go ahead and roll an extra die because you are an officer.
Okay. So, am I perception rolling and adding a third dice, or just two?
No, this is just two dice.
Okay. I got a six.
Okay. Unfortunately, so you do get a skill, and this skill, I'm going to say, should be related to the fact that you are an officer. So you've already got morale officer, but I would say something like maybe chain of command or something like that.
Intimidation.
Sure, something like that. But even though you're an officer, it still doesn't register your handprint.
Damn. It'd be like that.
I kick it.
That's not gonna do anything. Why the hell are you kicking things?
Because I like to kick things.
Wow.
You should have asked the woman professionality. Before she left. That's yours, incredibly professional. Mr. Lloyd.
Look. I heard somebody crying and I got drugs, okay, man? I come prepared.
Drug the rope.
Well, look. Melatonin isn't going to do shit on mechanics, so...
Oh, no. This wasn't melatonin, buddy. No.
Oh, I'm aware.
I'm curious.
Quote that, I think what the mainlanders call it, that good shit.
Oh, okay. I get you.
Not to bore you with the medical
XL
details.
Anyway, let's. I think we should go down. Someone should go. I think with.
I'll follow her. All right.
Let's see. And then me and. Why am I blanking on the name right now?
Floyd.
I what I do is I think of Pink Floyd and then I just take the F off.
Okay.
So Lloyd, Dr. Lloyd. Come with me. I think we should go to while Morthos is hanging out with the security officer lady. We should go down to the shipping department and check what they may have heard.
So I am actually going to focus on the shipping department first. So you two show up, and this big guy, kind of same build as Grigor, walks over.
Hello, Dr. Lloyd. Surprised to see you here. And Miller.
Yes.
Did we give you the wrong shipment of food? The wrong shipment of medication? Was something wrong?
So we are kind of having a bot emergency.
Bot emergency? Look, if it's something to do with bots, you don't want to talk to us. You want to talk to Anthony.
We already did that. Not good time.
As you know, Anthony's not the most helpful. But anyway, we talked to the nice woman in security, and she said that there was a report made about some noises, and that noises ended up being correlated to our emergency. Can you enlighten us as to what kind of noises you were talking about?
Well, it was weird. It was just kind of like this big metallic clang that happened a couple of times and then was gone. What's weird is that it wasn't coming from any of the crates. It was coming from kind of the greater area, but none of my crew saw anything.
Did you have any, like, broken crates, anything? Anything left open?
I haven't seen anything. You'd have to talk to... Actually, hold on.
Hey, Moko!
And this tiny little girl scurries over, just kind of like, yeah? Moko, these folks are asking about the crates. Any of them broken?
And or left kind of open, like, or...
Oh, no. Nothing happened with the crates. Everything's fine with the crates.
Can I roll for deception? The woman seems nervous.
Absolutely. You are allowed to use your empathy skill for this, so roll... Actually, roll four dice, because I'm going to let you use your therapist skill as well.
While he's rolling, can I, like, just a general look around? Like, to do, like a head span? Just look around the area, not, like, obviously move or anything, just kind of look.
It's full of crates. There's crates of all shapes and sizes. There's people moving crates around. There's people driving stuff around, like, you know, futuristic forklifts to kind of move crates to different areas. Yeah. Nothing seems out of the ordinary.
Okay.
Meme Lord, what did you get for that roll?
The highest one was a six.
Nice. So you are going to get a skill, level 4, in something to do with detecting lies.
We're gonna call it therapeutic, or yeah, therapeutic honesty.
Therapeutic honesty.
Ooh,
love
like
it.
That name.
That is a very good name. So yeah, you try to figure out. You use your therapy skills to try and figure out like what's wrong with her. Is she lying? And she's not. She's telling the honest truth. She is 100% telling the truth to you guys. But you don't know why she's this nervous if she's telling the truth.
Can I pull her aside?
Absolutely.
Away from, out of sight.
While you're pulling her aside, Morthos, the security officer, you're kind of tailing behind her. She books it into into the bridge and kind of goes, Captain, I need to speak with you. And she kind of pulls the captain aside, and Anthony kind of walks in, kind of very annoyed, sees you. Oh, great, you're here. Walks in with the captain, and you follow them in, and... You walk in with them. As you walk in, you find that the captain's there, the first officer is there, and the security officer is there, the head of security is there, Anthony's there, the chief engineer is there. Basically, this is like, hey, everyone that would be involved with robots is there.
Yeah.
And as you walk in, the captain turns and says, oh good, Morthos is here. We can begin then. And he turns to the security officer. Well then, Officer Woods, why did you call us here? Well, to kind of put things succinctly, Morthos here, Officer Morthos, and another member of the crew both reported seeing a large robot. Apparently it had a red dot on its forehead, and Anthony just kind of goes, leans back in his chair very annoyed. And the Officer Woods continues, and apparently it attacked a crew member, or at least it charged after them, and then vanished. There are scuff marks from Officer Morthos's encounter with it. Officer Morthos, was there any other evidence that you have on you from it?
Personally, no.
Okay. Well, there was there was evidence of it being there. Look, Anthony, I know you were already approached about this, but I feel like everyone needs to see this. And she pulls up on the monitor the video clip of the robot charging Miller. And everyone is just kind of like, what the... Even Anthony is a little awestruck by this. Just kind of like, what the fetch is that? And then the clip stops and everyone looks at Anthony, because he's in charge of the bots, right? And so they look at him, he's just kind of like, all I can say is that's not one of our bots. That is a decommissioned bot, and if it is actually here on this ship and is assaulting crew members like that, I have not heard anything about it. And the captain looks at Officer Morthos. Did the bot seem dangerous to you at all?
To me, personally, no. But it seems that it could perhaps be dangerous to people of a lower standing point, because the head chef, Miller, was attacked. And honestly, I did not know if it has attacked anyone else. But whenever I encountered it, it looked at me, almost seemed to scan me, it was disturbing, and just disappeared. Vanished.
If it is scanning you based on based on rank, then that means it's got a connection to the AI. And he kind of thinks for a moment, kind of puts pieces together. Chief Engineer Russell. And Chief Engineer sits up. Yes? Morthos.
Yes?
You have interactions with the AI. Chief Engineer Russell, you have interactions with the AI. Do either of you think that this is something the AI would be capable of, communicating with a robot and giving it this information?
Well, I definitely do think it would be possible, but I feel like it would probably have to have some outside interaction, connecting them to. I don't think it's the AI alone.
And Russell kind of straightens up. Yeah, I second what Martha said. But I will say there is a possibility that the robot has hacked into the AI and is utilizing it that way. Anthony, none of your bots have that capability, right? And Anthony shakes his head. No, that's something that gets pretty heavily tested, that robots can't hack into the AI. The AI is the dominant controller, not the robot. And the captain kind of steeples his fingers. Right. Well, in that case, I'm going to have to adjourn this meeting until we get further evidence that something is attacking the ship.
Maeve, how are you
Morthos,
doing?
Morthos, I want you to make an announcement.
We're doing good. We're playing.
Just have everyone know that there is a security problem on board the ship. It's minor right now, but that everyone should keep an eye out and report all suspicious activity to security.
I understand. You'll protect me, right, Mr. Captain?
And the captain just kind of looks at you. Now is not the time, officer. And you see both Russell and Woods kind of giving you the side eye, like, oh, clever, clever. But the captain is just like, no, now is not the time for this. This is serious, and it needs to be taken seriously.
A human doctor,
meeting
a
jerk,
psychologist,
and everyone gets up and leaves.
Spec is a morale
yes,
officer.
Yes, I'm going to go to my
bard,
post at the
demon
center,
based alien. I'm a cat based alien chef.
While I'm doing that, you can go ahead.
And we saw a big robot, and we're solving a mystery of what the fuck is going on.
So we cut back to the shipping department.
It's actually really cool.
Dr. Lloyd, what is your private conversation with Moku like?
It's Moku?
Moko. M-O-K-O.
Moko. Hey, Moko. I know you're not lying. I've seen a lot of people. It's okay. You can talk to me. But you're nervous, and it's critically important you tell me why you're nervous.
Okay. And she, she is on the verge of, she is profoundly nervous right now. It's very hard for her to get words out.
Moko, if this is something you've done, it's okay.
It's not me.
The crate's so pretty.
It's Vex. One of my coworkers, kind of looks like your compatriot, companion, friend here. He has been saying some things about me and said that if I don't keep my head down, there's going to be some trouble. And, I figured that you guys were the trouble, because what evidence was there to dissuade me from that?
Well, what have you been doing that's, to them, not keeping your head down?
I don't know. Vex likes to draw conclusions at the slightest opportunity. For all I know, he's just jealous that I'm a better worker than he is, and he's decided to, I don't know, morally demean me by sending a ship psychologist down to try and figure out if I'm lying.
No, that's not it at all. Actually, Moko, if there's any concern that you have ethically about you or anything happening in your department, I want you to come directly to me or the captain, okay?
Okay. Will do.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. She kind of goes back to her work. You notice there, like, she's a little bit happier, but she's still pretty nervous.
I hope you know, while you were talking to her, I was distracting the boss man, Moko, was it? Or was it the dude?
Vex.
Vex. Dawn is the boss man.
Dawn.
Vaughn.
Or Vaughn.
Yeah, Vex is one of the workers.
So Dawn Moko was the one we were talking to.
Or you Moko was the one Meme Lord was talking okay. to. Dawn is the one that called Dawn. Moko over and is kind of like the, yes, hello.
So I'm guessing he's like, so you? I was just distracting him by like talking how amazing like his space looks over here. Like it looks very and well like shit. Like is this like are there some of these like boxes that's like real like balsa wood, isn't it? Like I'm just distracting. Not even need to distract him. I'm just being like that. I'm just these boxes and crates, dude.
You didn't even have to say much, and he's just like talking. You can tell that this is something he loves talking about, and he doesn't get to talk about it a lot. But he's just like, yeah. This balsa wood, it's good, but it's not as good as the original. This is replicated balsa wood, and it's not as sturdy.
Oh,
and it's got problems. It's got defects. Replicators aren't very good at recreating balsa wood in particular. I don't know what it is. He's just talking on and on and on.
I want you to know I'm into it. I'm just like digging every second of like that. He's passionate. I got it.
Yeah, he's just this is very much a I have been waiting my entire life for this moment kind of thing happening here. And you can tell that he is having such a fun time that someone is actually like, someone cares about his job instead of just being like, yo, move those crates over to my office. Thank you. Go away. So.
I hope you know I want to be good friends with this man.
Yeah.
Can I talk to Vex?
All right. Vex is in a corner, kind of, he's slacking on the job is the kindest way to put it. He is sitting on a bench, eating a bag of replicated peanuts.
I hope you guys
peanuts,
in the chat know I really want to be friends. I want to just talk about like
the shells at his coworkers, kind of spitting them out of his mouth. He is
just talk about the metal.
A member of the same race as Miller, but
I'll be talking about my knives.
Definitely not the same.
This
like,
one is a
breed,
is a branded Kobasuba.
But what I'm hearing is it's an asshole cat.
Yes,
can I say something real quick?
It's Koshina.
Yeah.
Bitch is going against my orders. I said. We all have our things to pull. We all need to work. No just lounging around. Bitches lounging around and being a dick.
You know that's the reason that I put him in, yes? Because you gotta have that on character. So yeah, he's kind of sitting around just spitting peanuts at people. And as you come over, he's like...
Spitting peanuts at people?
What do you want?
Hey, Vex, buddy.
That's me. Just sitting in the back of the car.
Buddy.
Okay, Vex. Well, I see you're maybe picking on your coworkers. What's going on? Why do you seem so angry?
Why do you seem so interested in my private workings?
Well, see, that's literally my job. I was frozen for 60 years for this literal purpose. And I give a big smiley grin, just being as obnoxious and positive as possible.
I want to get some more.
He grabs a fistful of peanuts, very carefully deshells them all with his claws, stuffs them in his mouth, and then just hucks the rest of the shells at you. Go away!
This dude's turning into a pea shooter.
Thanks, buddy. I'll leave you alone. Here, I'll make you a deal. Tell me what the hell is going on in this department. And why Moko seems to be so fucking afraid of you.
I'm scared.
And you'll never see me again. But see, here's the contrary to that. If you don't, I will make your life a living hell.
Exactly. See you again.
So I want you to take the next couple seconds and decide what you want to do before you respond and you spit some peanut shells at me.
Wait,
Speck, we
didn't decide this.
Did your character
have horns like a tiefling?
Alright. You want the truth? Well, you can't handle the busting truth.
Look, I get in his face.
Try me.
I'm not scared of you, shrink. I'm more scared of Dawn than I am of you. And trust me, Dawn ain't gonna believe a word you say about
me. Over here talking
I'm
about
his
balsa
best
wood.
Worker.
Well, I don't report to Dawn. I don't give a shit what Dawn thinks.
Me over here talking to him about balsa wood.
Guess what?
He's like, he'll accept my word.
On this ship, it's eat or be eaten.
Moco has decided she's gonna be eaten. And I am more than happy to eat.
Do you understand?
And if you think you can save her from my maw, then you have messed with the wrong cat. So I advise you to leave before you get eaten. Understand, Padre?
Have a nice day, Vex. I hope to talk to you soon.
See you. Drink. And he spits another bunch of peanuts at you.
I wish I was there.
Now, we cut back to Spec. Do you want to do the announcement, or do you just want it to be the announcement has been done?
Spec?
Hello, Spec?
Are you?
I forgot to unmute myself. I'm so sorry.
All good.
Spec, no!
Spec!
Spec got knocked out of the speaking. Everything is awful.
There we go. Spec's back.
Right. Okay. Hi. I will make the announcement. What am I announcing again?
Spec, I believe
you. So the captain has asked you to make an announcement about ship
safety. Oh yeah, and then he got mad at me for flirting.
Yes.
Right. Okay. I can do this. Let's get the voice right. So I step up into my little auditorium with my announcing stuff. That's what you want to call it. My old setup.
Technical name.
I sit down, clear my throat, and I click on the microphone. Just do a little check 1, 2. Can everybody hear me? Yes? Not? Oh, this is fucking useless. There seems to be a little problem, and it is a bit dangerous out at the moment, but not for everyone. But if you can, just keep an eye out. We are currently working on this, and there's no need to panic. I would suggest walking around in pairs, that would probably be for the best. And either way, you won't get lost. It's for the best anyways. Everything is fine, but there is a small problem, as I have mentioned before. So, all of the higher ups have been working on it, and the AI will get... We will get everything situated, just be cautious, be careful, and don't go out alone, if you know what I'm saying. And that is really all I have to say. Good day, everyone, and have a pleasant ship life. I click it off and just shake my head because I knew that was absolute shit. But I'm honestly just concerned for everybody.
You hear from the background of the audience, "Woo, baby! That's what we've been waiting for! Woo!"
Love it.
Awesome.
Well, the captain looks at you, gives the thumbs up, goes back to his duties, and the head of security nods to you as he walks past. Good job. And everyone's leaving. And then, weirdly, Woods kind of lingers. She stares at you, she looks at the ground, she stares back at you, she smiles, and then she walks out.
Can I chase after her?
Absolutely.
To see why she's being so shady. Okay.
Absolutely.
So I stand up, like, dramatically, chair falls back. Big clatter. I ignore that, I don't even fucking fix it. I, like, dash out of my room and give chase to her.
Okay.
And I quickly grab her, like, just slightly below the shoulder, grab her on,
mm-hmm.
Like, Woods, Woods, apologies for just grabbing you like this, is there something that you need to say to me? You seemed pretty shady in the booth. Are you okay?
I'll be fine.
I guess in the academy, they never really told you how to react when something like this happens. They said, you're a security officer. You'll figure it out as you go. Now I'm stuck here on a spaceship in the middle of nowhere, and I have no idea how I'm going to figure this out. I don't know. I feel like you've got it more figured out than I do, and you're not even security. You're the friggin' morale officer. Your job is the complete opposite of mine.
Well, it's not that I've really got it down and I've got your job down better than yours. It's just more of... I'm just good at staying calm, you see? I'm nervous, but if you want, I can put you in with a session with Lloyd. Maybe that can calm you down. But you're doing great, honestly.
Listen, there's not really a good way to say this, and I apologize if it comes off the wrong way, but would you be willing to escort me to my quarters? I'm feeling a little anxious being alone here on the ship. Like, what if that robot shows back up?
I will be more than happy to do that. Just lead the way. I will protect you, I suppose.
Great. Thank you. And
yeah.
As you guys round a corner, and I'm gonna kind of at this point, like if this were a TV show episode, it does this split screen, and it shows Speck and Woods going towards the quarters, and it shows Lloyd and Miller in the cargo area talking with Dawn, and all of a sudden there's this gigantic metallic screeching noise that echoes and reverberates throughout the entire ship.
Oh dear.
And it's like you feel the floor shake underneath you, and then this weird voice gets on the speakers.
That's my job.
Hello, okay. Precious children. Would you like to play?
And that is where we're going to end tonight's session.
We're on in a space version of Jigsaw.
I'm
scared.
I don't.
I was thinking that or Silent Hill. I don't like it. I don't this one bit.
Oh dear.
Thank you so much to Speck, Meme Lord, and Blue for letting me be the narrator for this session.
Thank you
so much to the chat for being such an awesome chat tonight. And I don't know, I really want to do more of this. I would be more than happy to come back and do this if you guys want to see more of this.
Oh, I had fun. I had a lot of fun with this.
This was very fun. I am very excited to see where these characters go. And, Speck, I will apologize if I did anything to you that was not what you had intended for your character.
Oh, no, it's fine. Okay, honestly.
Perfect.
But, like, the only place I'm going at the end of this is in the bedroom with the captain.
Lovely.
It's all Speck wants.
This is Speck's end goal.
Yes.
And then also bringing up the rattle emotions of the security officer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
You're like, you're doing good.
But, Blue, I don't know what your plans are for the rest of your stream, but I need to head out because I have work I need to go to. So, until then, thank you guys so much for having me. To you in the chat and to you in the voice call with me, y'all rock. Y'all are special beans. I'm happy that I get to be in a stream and a Discord with y'all. And until next time, peace out.
Peace out. Have a good time at work, and thanks for doing it.